Oh, wow, I see it, yeah. Oh,
wow. Living life every day, late at night, not okay. All I want and I pray, all I need.
Good morning. We're now day two of the Antarctica cruise. There's no doubt we are in the Drake Passage now. The ship is swaying a lot.
Wow, look at the swell. Yeah. Well, this is just a swell of a few meters. So I think it's still considered as calm.
The original plan was to work out in the gym before breakfast. However, I was feeling a little bit seasick, and the thought of even getting on an exercise bike was just too much. So I will let Steve and others to enjoy the gym. I went back to the stateroom to lie on the bed until breakfast was ready to be served.
So this morning we're having breakfast at deck 2, and as it's the lowest deck, you can see the swell. It's already a bit calmer now. Earlier I could see the waves splashing against the window here.
Now, what is the Drake Passage? Named after the famed British privateer Sir Francis Drake, the Drake Passage is the area of the Southern Ocean between the bottom of South America, Cape Horn, and the Antarctica Peninsula, which is the most northerly part of the White Continent. Now, if you look at the globe, you will see the Drake Passage is where the Pacific, the Atlantic, and Southern Oceans converge. You will also see that there is no landmass between approximately latitude 55 south to 60 south, so you get really strong wind there, with no landmass to interrupt the eastward advance of the powerful Antarctic circumpolar current. You can get really rough seas here. Sometimes it can be calm. They say it's either the Drake Shake or the Drake Lake. When it's Drake Lake, the journey will be enjoyable with small waves and light winds, and you can just enjoy it like on a regular cruise, going out on decks, wildlife spotting, etc. But if it's Drake Shake, well, let's just say, I hope you brought your seasickness pills with you.
So today there are two mandatory briefings. The first one is the expedition briefing. That is at 9:30 a.m. And then the next one is 10:15 a.m. That one is the IAATO briefing. They mentioned that if you don't attend this meeting, you will not be allowed to get off at any points of this trip.
At the end of the Drake Passage, we will go to this South Shetland Island, and it's from this point it will start being a little bit protected. With the sea condition could be better, and then we're gonna try to go on this area, which will be even more protected. So in 2 days you will not be seasick again. And the landscapes are part of it, but it's not the only one. We see many ice, a lot of ice cubes and so on, and not only in your glasses at the bar, but especially on the feet, so sea ice, iceberg ice, snow maybe, and it's always changing, and Antarctica is never the same. Of course, we try to see some wildlife. We hope to see penguins, seals, birds, maybe whales. We'll start to go here in this small bay, which is called Neko Harbor, and that might be the first continental landing, we hope so. First day, first continental landing to the South Shetland Island, and then we sail back. And now I will let them introduce themselves, starting with my assistant, David.
We have this presentation, which is mandatory, and I will talk about IAATO, so the International Association of Antarctica Tour Operators. And this afternoon, you will have the decontamination process, and I will talk about this in this presentation.
And then you have these stairs here going back, going down to the marina. So here we are at deck 2, and you will have to walk on this small vircon solution, as I said. And after this, the ABs, the sailors, will help you to embark on the Zodiac.
The captain earlier mentioned the swell is about 4 meters, which is somewhat between the Drake Lake and Drake Shake. So the list has been published. We'll find our name. After all the mandatory briefings, it's time for the World Cup final between France and Argentina. The ship had organized a live screening of the match at the theater. I watched a bit of it, but I spent most of my time recording the ship tour of Le Boreal. And it was a good time to do so, as it was sunny outside and the ship was very quiet. If you haven't watched the ship tour video yet, you can click on the link above or at the end of this video to watch it. I then had a small lunch as I was still feeling a bit seasick at that stage. After lunch, we were invited to bring our Zodiac life jacket as well as bags that we may use for Antarctic landings to the observatory lounge for the decontamination process. Basically, we have to clean all those items thoroughly so that we do not bring seeds or anything that would disrupt the ecosystem of Antarctica. So it's afternoon tea time. They got sandwiches, lots of brownies, and macaroons and cakes. Day 2 evening is the first of the two gala evening. Tonight at 6:45, at the theater, there will be a welcome drinks with captain. Everyone has to dress up, scrub up nicely. After that will be the first gala dinner. Right, we're dressed up for the night.
Welcome to the Drake Passage. Tonight, I have the pleasure and the honor to introduce you the greatest authority on board of our vessel ce soir. J'ai le grand plaisir et l'honneur de vous présenter l'autorité la plus importante à bord de notre navire. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, the master of Le Boreal, Captain Michael Debien.
Tonight we have a wonderful evening for you. As it was a captain's cocktail, I have decided to talk a little bit about me. I grew in Vendée, in the Atlantic coast of France. I sail since I am 6 years old. I always do some sailing boat, and later I decided to join the merchant marine, where I start on a tanker ship, super liquid tanker ship, and different vessel, but very different from Le Boreal. In 1998, I joined a small French company, which was Compagnie des Îles du PONANT, which is not PONANT. And so since this time, I work with PONANT, and I work on Le Levant, beautiful yacht, and later 14 years on Le PONANT, the sailing boat, and many years as captain, and I'm captain since almost 15 years with PONANT, and since 7 years on Le Boreal and the sister ship, on the Antarctic and Arctic area. Of course, when you sail, you met some people, and I met a beautiful woman on Le Ponant, and we are married since many years now. And we have a daughter of 15 years old.
So tonight is the gala dinner, and this is the menu for tonight. So this one is the amuse-bouche. It's got caviar. So there are two starters. The first one is a cold starter, and it's a lobster with black truffles. Next up is a hot starter, and it looks like it's cold. Okay, the main course has arrived. It's a beef steak, and it looks really nice and cold. So the dessert is a pavlova. Good morning, this is now day 3 of the Antarctica cruise. We are still crossing the Drake Passage. This is the second day of the Drake Passage. Today the weather is a lot cloudier, and it definitely feels a little bit colder than yesterday. The sea, I would say, is not as rough. The first activity this morning is to try out boots. So they have boots for all feet size. These boots are very deep because we are gonna have to do wet landings, and we'll have to wear waterproof trousers that go over the boots. next, we'll learn how to clean these boots, and then we'll get our parka jacket.
This one looks fairly new, so...
Yeah, but still, there is few works, you see.
Yes.
And the thing is, it's where, like, all the stuff, like the penguin faces will go. And after, you can make some huge troubles in the colony because of that.
Oh.
So be really careful about that.
Okay.
So, the next step is to clean the boots. Finally, we got our parka jacket after trying on different sizes.
So we just have a trivia, and after a very tightly contested contest, I won in the shootout at the end. I got 35 out of 40 correct, and there's another team that also did the same amount correct answer. And it came down to some tiebreakers, and we both either got them correctly or incorrectly. But at the end, we got the last question right, which is, where is Kilimanjaro? And then the answer was, of course, Tanzania.
So we won the trivia, and these are the prizes. First, it's a little notepad, PONANT notepad. What's this? It's a glasses case. And finally, this is quite nice. What's inside here is actually a charging cable. This one is a Apple Lightning cable. Earlier, we got a little bit excited because the cruise director was joking that the price for this is a free cruise. But of course not. They're not going to give away thousands of pounds of worth of a cruise in a trivia like this. So the bridge is currently open. Let's go inside. So, exciting news, I just went to the bridge to talk to the officers there. We actually entered the Antarctic convergence last night already. And right now, I'm looking at the moving map, and I could see we're actually in Antarctica already. Can't quite see the land yet, and apparently we should probably see land in 2-3 hours, later around 3 o'clock. It's now 12, which is lunchtime, so we're gonna go have lunch first. The sea is definitely much calmer now that we have passed through the Drake Passage. It's interesting, the Drake Passage has been a lot less rough than I had expected, which I'm really pleased about. No seasickness, but I have taken some pills, but even then, it was relatively okay. After lunch and a bit of a rest, there was a bachata dance class. I gave it a pass, but Steve tried. Then, it was time for another enrichment talk. This time, it's all about the history of Antarctic exploration. There was first a talk on the race to the South Pole between Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen and the British expedition led by Robert Scott. Ultimately, Amundsen won because Scott's team was ravaged by scurvy. Scott died of cold, exhaustion, and hunger, but the scurvy didn't help. We also learn about the heroics of Ernest Shackleton's Antarctic expeditions. Most notably, the Endurance expedition, where the ship got trapped in pack ice and was slowly crushed, and how the crew escaped by camping on the sea ice, and how they eventually abandoned ship and launched lifeboats, and how they reached Elephant Island by rowing resolutely, and the crew surviving being stranded on the island for months. As much as we enjoyed the lecture, as soon as it was finished, we rushed to the open deck on the aft of Deck 6 because we heard that we were finally seeing land, the Antarctic land.
Wow! Hey guys, we're finally in Antarctica. You can actually see land. Wow! Oh my god, this is spectacular. This is the first little iceberg I've seen. Look at how blue it is.
We are really lucky. Our first impression of the white continent is a sunny blue sky. Look at this iceberg. It looks like an ice dragon to me.
Now, if you enjoyed this video so far, please give me a thumbs up. This will really help the channel grow, as YouTube will then spread the video to more viewers. And if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to my channel with notifications enabled. This way, you will be notified whenever I release a new video.
Even though you might have done lots of research about it, the first time you're seeing this is just really magical still. The impact of seeing snow, iceberg everywhere, it's just quite stunning. So obviously, this is the first time I'm seeing all these. I do wonder after the next 4 or 5 days whether I will get bored seeing this. I don't know. I can't imagine feeling that yet. Oh wow, I see it, yeah. Oh wow. Oh. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. Yeah. Oh wow. So hopefully you all managed to see it in the video earlier. We saw a humpback whale. It was very difficult to capture it because it's moving very fast, and I tried to zoom in.
Because you have this kind of form because of the egg white.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's time to have a cocktail.
Negroni feast.
Or two.
Okay, so when we were in Sandals, Bahamas, we were introduced to a cocktail called Espresso Martini. And it was gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And they do it here too on the cruise ship. Let me test it. This one actually is more coffee. Very smooth.
It's getting cloudier now, although it still looks amazing. Anyway, it's time to head down to the theater for the expedition talk.
A small island on the starboard side of the ship. It was a Melchior Island, meaning the small that are here. And tonight we're gonna leave this Dalman Bay and heading south in a bigger bay, which is called Anvor Bay, this one, in order to reach our first area, our first stop here, Neko Harbor. And we will try to offer you a continental landing, meaning that, yes! meaning that, yes, we will try to put the feet on the continent. The forecast for tomorrow in Anvor Bay in Neko Harbor is quite good. When it's blue, it's good.
Too not only.
When it's this blue, it's good. But when it's this blue, it's not good. Okay, blue, yellow will be the first group, and then the red at 9:15. So 8, 8:15, 9:15, 9:30. Able to reach to go through this very narrow passage. It's called Aguirre Passage. But it's not possible, we can go like this, it's a bit longer, but we can do it.
There is no sharks in Antarctica. Why? Let's talk about oceanography.
It's too cold.
Because, you know, there is many species that isolate the rest of the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Ocean. It's another mass of water. Imagine at the surface, you have salty water, so dense, that sinks. And then, you see? Didn't mix. So you have actually all around Antarctica this kind of cascading water, very dense because salty and cold going through. This is actually the fuel of this current. You see what I mean? So underwater in Antarctica, you find many huge species that usually are tiny and they are endemic.
After the talk, we were told that humpback whales were back. So we all immediately rushed to the outside deck again. this time the whales are even closer to us. I will end the video here and leave you to enjoy the footages of these humpback whales breaching. And make sure you subscribe, as next time we'll show our first continental landing on Antarctica.
Oh wow. Oh wow.